Hi, welcome to the Rise Up and Live YouTube channel. My name is Kelly Rissi and I'm the owner of Rise Up and Live Wellness. During these videos, you will hear things about health, life, and mindset to help you live your best life, such as how to decrease and manage stress, how to get better sleep, how to set boundaries, how to eat mindfully, how to build confidence, how to live spiritually, and so much more. So thanks for joining, and I hope you enjoy my To The Points. And here is a little throwback for you.
So today we are talking about boundaries. You know, as I really started diving in to the boundary topic, I realized that, wow, it's super important. It's important to our health. It's important to our life. It's important to the choices that we make. And the word boundaries might even be new to some of you. So we're gonna dive into this over the next few weeks and, you know, kind of get a little bit deeper each week. But today I just wanna, you know, kind of talk about what are boundaries. So boundaries are limits, parameters, confines, and compass. That's how Webster defines it. And, you know, honestly, I love limits, but I love compass. Because when we are living in truly healthy boundaries, we are following our compass in the direction that we need to go for life. When our compass is off, then we are struggling with something. Our stress is higher. We have struggles in relationships. We have struggles in our health. And so it is really important to understand this whole concept around boundaries. So I feel like if we think about when we are kids or the kids that we have, either one, we're pretty good about giving kids boundaries, right? So we have a certain bedtime for them. We have, you know, we monitor who their friends are. Like, we give them boundaries. We give them boundaries of where they can go, right? When they're little, you know, stay on the patio. Then they get bigger and they get the whole rein of the backyard. And then when they get a little bit bigger, they can move to the front yard. And then as they continue to grow, they might be able to go down the street. And so we have boundaries of where our kids can go. As they become teens, we have a curfew, right? That's a boundary. It's a time boundary. You know, we want to make sure that their homework is completed. And so we have boundaries around when they're doing that. So I think if we think back to like how we are raising our children or were raised, then that kind of helps us think about boundaries a little bit. So another way that I want to like help you really kind of visualize boundaries is if you think about your property. So on your property, you know where your property lines are. When you buy a home, they tell you exactly where one side of your yard is, the other, where the back is, where the front is, and you know exactly what your property is, okay? And then people often put up fences. And so a fence does a couple of things. A fence is going to protect what is in it. Right? So if we think about boundaries like fences, you are protecting your values, what you hold dear to you. If it's your children, that fence is protecting them. If it's your dogs out there, that fence is protecting them. Then, so fences keep the good in and protect it. Fences also keep the bad out. Right? So your boundaries, you are keeping the things that you disagree with, the unhealthy things, you are keeping those out. And then let's talk about the gate. So most fences have at least one gate, and the gate is to get any bad that is in to get it out, right? It's got to have a way to get out, and so it needs a gate. So that's kind of a way to think about your boundaries. So for me, here's some examples of unhealthy boundaries that came up in my life. So at one point in my life, I was promiscuous, right? So my sexual boundaries were unhealthy. When I was an educator, I had unhealthy boundaries because I was spending so much time working, right? And I didn't have to, just so you know, none of my principals were telling me work more, work more, work more. I was doing that. It was an unhealthy boundary for me that I set for myself. And so I wasn't spending enough time with my family. That was a boundary that I kind of crossed over, and it went into too much work and not enough family time. Let's talk about health. We get boundaries around our health, right? So if you are an emotional eater, if you are an overeater, if you are a binge eater, if you are a restrictive eater, those are all boundaries. You are crossing boundaries with all of those, okay? So in the health world, there are different boundaries. Exercise, right? So if you are not exercising, then you don't really have a healthy boundary around taking care of your body. Okay, things like that. That goes along with eating as well, right? So those are boundaries. Your calendar. If your calendar is too full and you are saying yes to everything and you have no downtime, your stress level is probably high because you're moving too fast, doing too many things. And so saying, honoring your yes and no is a boundary, okay, for your calendar. I think about like a boundary for me, my house. Like I have a boundary on how messy my house can get. And then after that, that's enough. Like I have that line, that limit. And if I let it go beyond that, then it becomes emotional, right? I'm stressed out because there's too much clutter. Things aren't where they need to go. That raises my stress level. That raises my cortisol. That affects my health. So having boundaries, around your clutter is big. And then we also, one of the other boundaries is what you really value and what you really hold true. Those are values. So I have a boundary around what I believe spiritually. I will listen to other people. I will accept their and respect their opinion, but I am not compromising my boundary. And so there's that intellectual boundaries around what we truly believe and what ideas we have. There was a time in my life, and this had to do with my health, that I crossed into a boundary that ended up not being good for me because I was following what someone else is doing, which was great for them, not great for me. And so physically, mentally, spiritually, that was not good for me. And so that was a boundary that I really had to look at. So next week, what we're going to really dive into is the different types of boundaries and how we see boundaries. So your boundaries can be too rigid, your boundaries can be too loose, or your boundaries can be healthy. And so we're going to dive into that a little bit more, as well as just the different areas that, in your life where you're going to have like boundaries. There's six of them. So I'm going to talk about that next week. So anyway, I am curious to know, just comment below on this whole boundaries thing. On a scale of 1 to 10, like, where are you with boundaries? Do you know about boundaries? Do you not know about boundaries? Do you feel like you think you hold some healthy boundaries, but you know you have areas? I don't know, whatever it is of boundaries that comes up for you, like, oh, that fences and gate things, that was a new concept for me. Whatever it is, comment below so that I just know that where we are as a group, as like my Rise Up and Live followers, what's going, like where you are with boundaries and knowing, so that I kind of know where to go. Because I know that there are people that this is new to. They're like, oh, boundaries, like that is totally new. And so I would love to know that, or like I have done research on boundaries, I know boundaries, I hold my boundaries. Where are you on that? And let's just go from there, and we'll dive in more next week on boundaries. Stay tuned. All right, y'all, have a great day.
If you enjoyed this video and want to hear more health, life, and mindset tricks and tips, I hope you'll subscribe to my YouTube channel. You can also check me out on social media and my website at www.riseupandlivewellness.com. Have a great day.